can't sleep.
Jesus, you scared me.
Sorry.
What are you doing here?
Well, I thought I'd check up on you. Why aren't you in bed?
Your student is still here. He's up in your study.
Well, he can let himself out.
I might as well wait up till he's done.
He's not my student anymore. He's teaching now. Bright kid.
What time is it?
Almost one.
Huh.
After midnight.
So?
Well, so? Happy birthday.
Dad?
Do I ever forget?
Thank you.
25. I can't believe it.
Neither can I. Should we have it now?
Oh, it's up to you.
Yes.
Would you like me to open it?
Let me. Last time you opened a bottle of champagne out here, you broke a window.
That was a long time ago. I resent your bringing it up.
You're lucky you didn't lose an eye.
25.
I feel old.
Oh, you're a kid.
Glasses?
Oh, God damn it! I forgot the glasses. Do you want me to...
Nah.
I hope you like it. I wasn't sure what to get you.
This is the worst champagne I've ever tasted.
Well, I'm proud to say I don't know anything about wines. I hate those kinds of people who are always talking about vintages.
It's not even champagne.
What bottle is the right shape?
Great Lakes Vineyards. I didn't know they made one in Wisconsin.
The girl who's drinking from the bottle shouldn't complain. But don't guzzle it. It's an elegant beverage.
Simp. Do you?
No, thank you.
You sure?
Yeah, it's your birthday.
Happy birthday to me.
What are you going to do on your birthday?
Drink this. Have some.
No. I hope you're not spending your birthday alone.
I'm not alone.
Well, I don't count.
Why not?
Well, I'm your old man. Go out with some friends.
Right.
Your friends aren't taking you out?
No.
Why not?
Because in order for your friends to take you out, you generally have to have friends.
Ah.
It's funny how that works.
Oh, you have friends? What about that cute blonde? What was her name?
What?
Well, she lives over on Ellis Avenue. You used to spend every minute together.
Cindy Jacobson?
Cindy Jacobson.
That was in third grade, Dad. We moved to Florida in 1998.
Well, what about Claire?
She's not my friend. She's my sister. And she's in New York. And I don't like her.
I thought she was coming in.
Not till tomorrow.
Well, my advice, if you find yourself awake late at night, is to sit down and do some mathematics.
Please.
We could do some together.
No.
Why not?
I can't think of anything worse. Are you sure you don't want any?
Yeah, thanks. You used to love it.
Not anymore.
You knew what a prime number was before you could read.
Well, now I've forgotten.
Don't waste your talent, Catherine.
I knew you'd say something like that.
I realize you've had a difficult time.
Thanks.
That's not an excuse. Don't be lazy.
I haven't been lazy. I've been taking care of you.
Oh, kid, I've seen you. You sleep till noon. You eat junk. You don't work. The dishes pile up in the sink. If you go out, it's to buy magazines. You come home with a stack of magazines this high. I don't know how you read that crap. And those are the good days. Some days you don't get up. Some days you don't get out of bed.
Those are the good days.
Bullshit! Those days are lost. You threw them away, and you'll never know what else you threw away with them. Work you never did, ideas you lost, discoveries you never made because you were up in your bed at 4 in the afternoon. You know I'm right.
I lost a few days.
How many?
I don't know.
I bet you do.
What?
I bet you count.
Knock it off.
Well, do you know or don't you?
I don't.
Well, of course you do. How many days have you lost?
A month. Around a month.
Exactly.
God damn it.
How many?
33 days.
Exactly.
I don't know.
Be precise, for Christ's sake.
I slept till noon today.
We'll call it 33 and a quarter days.
Yes, all right.
You're kidding!
No.
Amazing number!
It's a depressing fucking number.
Well, Catherine, if every day you say you lost were a year, it would be a very interesting fucking number.
33 and a quarter years is not interesting.
Oh, stop it. You know exactly what I mean.
1,729 weeks.
1,729. Great number. The smallest number expressible.
Is a sum of two cubes in two different ways.
12 cubed plus 1 cubed equals 1,729.
And 10 cubed plus 9 cubed. Yes, we've got it. Thank you.
Well, you see, even your depression is mathematical. Stop moping around and get to work. The kind of potential
you have. I haven't done anything good.
You're young. You've got time.
I do.
Of course.
By the time you were my age, you'd be famous.
By the time I was your age, I'd already done my best work.
What about after?
After what?
After you got sick.
What about it?
You couldn't work then.
No, if anything, I was sharper.
Dad!
I was! Hey, it's true. The clarity, that was the amazing thing, no doubts.
You were happy?
Well, yeah, I was busy.
Not the same thing.
Well, I don't see the difference. I knew what I wanted to do and I did it. If I wanted to work a problem all day long, I did it. If I wanted to look for secrets, complex and tantalizing messages, I could find them all around me. In the air. In a pile of fallen leaves some neighbor had raked together. Written in box scores in the paper or in the steam coming off of a cup of coffee. The whole world was talking to me. If I just wanted to close my eyes, sit quietly on the porch and listen for the messages, I did that. It was wonderful.
How old were you when it started?
Mid-20s, 23, 4. What, is that what you're worried about?
I've thought about it.
Just getting a year older means nothing, Catherine.
It's not just getting older.
It's me.
I've thought about it.
Really?
How can I not?
Well, if that's why you're worried, you're not keeping up with the medical literature. There's all sorts of factors. It's not simply something you inherit. Just because I went bughouse doesn't mean you would.
Dad.
No, listen to me. Life changes fast in your early 20s and it shakes you up. Feeling down, it's been a bad week. You've had a lousy couple of years. No one knows that better than me. But you're gonna be all right.
Yeah?
Yes. I promise you. Push yourself. Don't read so many magazines. Sit down and get the machinery going, and I swear to God, you'll feel fine. The simple fact that we can talk about this together is a good sign.
A good sign?
Of course.
How could it be a good sign?
Well, because crazy people don't sit around wondering if they're nuts.
They don't.
Well, of course not. They've got better things to do. Well, take it from me. A very good sign that you're crazy is the inability to ask the question, am I crazy?
Even if the answer is yes?
Well, crazy people don't ask, you see?
Yes.
So if you're asking...
I'm not.
No, but if you were, it would be a very good sign.
A good sign.
A good sign that you're fine.
Right.
You see, you've just got to think these things through. Now, come on, what do you say? You can go up, get some sleep, and then in the morning we can...
Wait. No.
Oh, what's the matter?
It doesn't work.
Well, sure it does.
No.
Why not?
It doesn't make sense.
Oh, of course it does.
No.
What's the problem?
The problem is you are crazy.
What difference does that make?
You just admitted. You just told me that you are.
Oh, so?
You said a crazy person would never admit that.
Well, yeah, but it's, Oh. I see.
So?
It's a point.
So how can you admit it?
Well, because I'm also dead, aren't I?
He died a week ago.
Heart failure. Quick. Funeral's tomorrow.
That's why Claire's flying in from New York.
Yes.
You're sitting here. You're giving me advice. You brought me champagne.
Yes.
Which means...
For you?
Yes.
For you, Catherine. My daughter, who I love very much. It could be a bad sign.
What?
Oh, God, sorry. Did I wake you?
What?
Were you asleep?
You scared me, for Christ's sake. What are you doing?
I'm sorry, I didn't realize it had gotten so late. I'm done for the night.
Good.
Drinking alone?
Yes.
Champagne, huh?
Yes.
Celebrating?
No. I just like champagne.
It's festive.
What?
Festive.
Do you want some?
Sure.
You can take the rest with you. I'm done.
Oh, no thanks.
Take it. I'm done.
I shouldn't. I'm driving. Well, I can let myself out.
Good.
When should I come back?
Come back?
Yeah, I'm nowhere near finished. Maybe tomorrow?
We have a funeral tomorrow.
Oh, God, you're right. I'm sorry. I was going to attend, if that's all right.
Yes.
What about Sunday? Will you be around?
You've had 3 days.
I'd love to get some more time up there.
How much longer do you need?
Another week, at least.
Are you joking?
No. Do you know how much stuff there is?
A week.
I know you don't need anybody in your hair right now. Look, I spent the last couple of weeks getting everything sorted out. It's mostly notebooks. He dated them all. Now that I've got them in order, I don't have to work here. I could take some stuff home and read it and bring it back.
No.
I'll be careful.
My father wouldn't want anything moved, and I don't want anything to leave his house.
Then I should work here. I'll stay out of the way.
You're wasting your time.
Someone should go through your dad's papers.
There's nothing up there. It's garbage.
There are 103 notebooks.
I've looked at those. It's gibberish.
Someone should read them.
He was crazy.
Yes, but he wrote them.
He was a graphomaniac, Harold. Do you know what that is?
I know. He wrote compulsively. Call me Hal.
There's no connection between the ideas. I mean, there's no ideas. It's like a monkey at a typewriter. 103 notebooks full of bullshit.
Let's make sure they're bullshit.
I'm sure.
I'm prepared to look at every page. Are you?
No. I'm not crazy.
Well, I'm gonna be late. Some friends of mine are in this band. They're playing in a bar up on Diversity. Way down the bill. They're going on around 2:30. I said I'd be there.
Great.
They're all in the math department. They're really good. They have this great song. You'd like it. It's called I. Just lowercase I. They just stand there and don't play anything for 3 minutes.
Imaginary number.
It's a math joke. You see why they're way down the bill.
Long drive to see some nerds in a band.
God, I hate when people say that. It's not that long a drive.
So they are nerds.
Oh, they're raging geeks. They're geeks who, you know, can dress themselves, hold down a job at a major university. Some of them switch from glasses to contacts. They play sports, they play in a band, they get laid surprisingly often. So in that sense, it sort of makes you question the whole set of terms. You know, geek, nerd, wonk, weeb, Dilbert, paste eater.
You're in this band, aren't you?
Okay, yes, I play drums. Do you want to come? I never sing, I swear to God.
No thanks.
All right. Look, Catherine, Monday, what do you say?
Don't you have a job?
Yeah, I have a full teaching load this quarter, plus my own work.
Plus band practice?
I don't have time to do this, but I'm going to. I loved your dad. I don't believe a mind like his could just shut down. He had lucid moments. He had a lucid year, a whole year, 4 years ago.
It wasn't a year. It was more like 9 months.
A school year. He was advising students. I was stalled in my PhD. I was like this close to quitting. I met with your dad and he put me on the right track with my research. I owe him.
Sorry.
Let me, you're 25, right?
How old are you?
It doesn't matter. Listen.
Fuck you. How old are you?
I'm 28, all right? When your dad was younger than both of us, he made major contributions to three fields. Game theory, algebraic geometry, and nonlinear operator theory. And most of us never get our heads around one. He basically invented the mathematical techniques for studying rational behavior, which the economists have been milking for Nobels ever since. And he gave the astrophysicists plenty to work with too, all right?
Don't lecture me.
I'm not. I'm telling you, if I came up with 1/10 of the shit your dad produced, I could write my own ticket to any math department in the country.
Give me your backpack.
What?
Give me your backpack.
Why?
I want to look inside it.
What?
Open it and give it to me.
Oh, come on.
You're not taking anything out of this house.
I wouldn't do that.
You're hoping to find something upstairs that you can publish.
Sure.
Then you can write your own ticket?
What? No, it would be for your dad. It would be under your dad's name.
I don't believe you. You have a notebook in that backpack.
What are you talking about?
I'm saying you're lying to me and stealing my family's property.
I think that sounds paranoid.
Paranoid?
Maybe a little.
Okay, fuck you, Hal. I know you have one of my notebooks.
You just said yourself there's nothing up there, didn't you? Didn't you say that? So what would I take, right?
You're right.
Thank you.
So you don't need to come back.
Please, someone should know for sure whether
or not... I lived with him. I spent my life with him. I fed him. Talked to him. Tried to listen when he talked. Talked to people who weren't there. Watched him shuffling around like a ghost. Very smelly ghost. He was filthy. I had to make sure he bathed. My own father.
I'm sorry, I shouldn't have.
After my mother died, it was just me here. No, I tried to keep him happy no matter what idiotic project he was doing. He used to read all day. He kept demanding more and more books. I took him out of the library by the carload. We had hundreds upstairs. Then I realized he wasn't reading. He believed aliens were sending him messages through the Dewey Decimal numbers on the library books. He was trying to work out the code.
What kinds of messages?
Beautiful mathematics. Most elegant proofs. Perfect proofs. Proofs like music.
Sounds good.
Plus fashion tips. Knock-knock jokes. I mean, it was nuts, okay?
He was ill. It was a tragedy.
Later, the writing phase. scribbling 19, 20 hours a day. I ordered him a case of notebooks and he used every one. I dropped out of school. I'm glad he's dead.
I can understand why you'd feel that way.
Fuck you.
No, you're right. It must have been awful. I know you...
You don't know me. I want to be alone. I don't want him around.
Him? I don't...
You. I don't want you here.
Why not?
He's dead.
But I'm not...
He's dead. I don't need any proteges around.
There will be others.
What?
You think I'm the only one? People are already looking over his stuff. Someone's gonna read those notebooks.
I'll do it.
No, you...
He's my father. I'll do it.
You can't.
Why not?
You don't have the math. It's all just squiggles on a page. You wouldn't know the good stuff from the junk.
It's all junk.
If it's not, we can't afford to miss any through carelessness.
I know mathematics.
If there's anything up there, it'd be pretty high order. It would take a professional to recognize it.
I think I could recognize it.
Kathy.
What?
I know your dad taught you some basic stuff, but come on.
You don't think I could do it.
I'm sorry. I know you couldn't. Hey! Give me a break. Come on. This isn't an airport.
You can come tomorrow.
The University Health Service is very good. My mom died a couple years ago, and I was pretty broken up about it. Also, my work wasn't going that well. I went and talked to this doctor. I saw her for a couple months, and it really helped.
I'm fine.
Also, exercise is great. I run along the lake a couple mornings a week. If you wanted to come, I could pick you up. We wouldn't have to talk.
No, thanks.
All right, I better get going. I'm gonna be late.
Okay.
It's seriously like 20 minutes up to the club. We go on, we play, we're terrible, we buy everyone drinks to make up for it afterwards. You're home by 4:30 tops.
Good night.
Good night.
Oh, wait, your coat.
Oh, no, you don't have to.
Paranoid?
Wait.
I think I should go jogging.
Just hold on.
Get out.
Can I please
get
just...
Get the fuck out of my house!
Listen to me for a minute.
You stole this!
Let me explain.
You stole it from me! You stole it from my father!
I wanted to show you something. Will you calm
down?
Get
it back.
Just wait a minute.
I'm calling the police.
Don't. Look, I borrowed the book, alright? I picked it up before I came downstairs and I thought...
Hello?
I did it for a reason.
Hello, police? Yes,
I noticed something.
A robbery
something your father
progress.
Wrote, not math. Something
a
you
robbery.
Wrote. Will you put the fucking
yes,
phone down and
listen to me?
It's about you. See, you. Cappy. Here's your name. Cappy, see? A good day. Some very good news from Catherine. I didn't know what that referred to, but I thought you might.
When did he write this?
I think 4 years ago. The handwriting is steady. It must have been during his remission. There's more. Machinery not working yet, but I am patient. The machinery is what he called his mind, his ability to do mathematics.
I know.
I know I'll get there. I am an auto mechanic who, after years of greasy work on a hopeless wreck, turns the key in the ignition and hears a faint cough. I'm not driving yet, but there's cause for optimism. Talking with students helps. So does eating meals in restaurants, being outside, riding buses, all the activities of normal life. Most of all, Catherine. The years she has lost caring for me. I almost wrote wasted. Yet her refusal to let me be institutionalized, her keeping me at home, caring for me herself, has certainly saved my life. Made writing this possible. Made it possible to imagine doing math again. Where does her strength come from? I can never repay her. Today is her birthday. She is 21. I'm taking her to dinner. Dated September 4th. That's tomorrow.
It's today.
You're right. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have tried to sneak it out. I thought you might want to see it. Tomorrow I was going to... It sounds stupid now. I was going to wrap it. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
better. Much.
Thanks.
Feel better?
Yeah.
You look a million times better. Have some coffee.
Okay.
How do you take it?
Black.
Have a little milk. I want a banana. It's a good thing I brought food. There was nothing in the house.
I've been meaning to go shopping.
Have a bagel.
No. I hate breakfast.
You didn't put on the dress.
Didn't really feel like it.
Don't you want to try it on, see if it fits?
I'll put it on later.
If you want to dry your hair, I have a hair dryer.
Yeah.
Did you use that conditioner I brought you?
No. Shit, I forgot.
It's my favorite. You'll love it, Katie. I want you to try it.
I'll use it next time.
You'll like it. It has jojoba.
What is jojoba?
It's something they put in for healthy hair.
Hair is dead.
What?
It's dead tissue. You can't make it healthy.
Whatever. Something that's good for your hair.
What, a chemical?
No, it's organic.
Well, it can be organic and still be a chemical.
I don't know what it is.
Haven't you ever heard of organic chemistry?
It makes my hair feel, look, and smell good. That's the extent of my information about it. You might like it if you decide to use it.
Thanks. I'll try it.
Good. I thought we'd have some people over tonight. If you're feeling okay.
I'm feeling okay, Claire. Stop saying that.
You don't have any plans?
No.
I ordered some food. Wine, beer.
We are burying Dad this afternoon.
I think it will be all right. Anyone who's been to the funeral and wants to come over for something to eat can. And it's the only time I can see any old Chicago friends. It'll be nice. It's a funeral, but we don't have to be completely grim about it. If it's okay with you.
Yes, sure.
It's been a stressful time. It would be good to relax in a low-key way. Mitch says hi.
Hi, Mitch.
He's really sorry he couldn't come.
Yeah, he's gonna miss all the fun.
He wanted to see you. He sends his love. I told him you would see him soon enough. We're getting married.
No shit.
Yes, we just decided.
Yikes.
Yes.
When?
January.
Huh.
We're gonna do a huge thing. These folks are going to. Just City Hall, then a big dinner at our favorite restaurant for all our friends. And you, of course. I hope you'll be in the wedding.
Yeah, sure. Congratulations, Claire. I'm really happy for you.
Thanks. Me too. We just decided it was time. His job is great. I just got promoted. You will come.
Yeah, sure. January. I mean, I don't have to check my calendar or anything.
That makes me very happy. How are you?
Okay.
How are you feeling about everything?
About everything?
About Dad?
What about him?
How are you feeling about his death? Are you all right?
Yes.
Honestly,
yes.
I think in some ways it was the right time. If there ever is a right time. Do you know what you want to do now?
No.
Do you want to stay here?
I don't know.
Do you want to go back to school?
I haven't thought about it.
Well, there's a lot to think about. How do you feel?
Physically? Great. Except my hair seems kind of unhealthy. I wish there was something to do about that.
Come on, Catherine.
What is the point of all these questions?
policeman came by. While you were in the shower?
Yeah.
They said they were checking up on things here. Seeing how everything was this morning.
That was nice.
They told me they responded to a call last night and came to the house.
Yeah.
Did you call the police last night?
Yeah.
Why?
I thought the house was being robbed.
But it wasn't.
No. I changed my mind.
First you call 911 with an emergency, and then you hang up on them.
I didn't really want them to come.
So why did you call?
I was trying to get this guy out of the house.
Who?
One of Dad's students.
Dad hasn't had any students for years.
No, he was Dad's student. Now he's a mathematician.
Why was he in the house in the first place?
He's been coming here to look at Dad's notebooks.
In the middle of the night?
It was late. I was waiting for him to finish, and last night I thought he might have been stealing them.
Stealing the notebooks?
Yes. So I told him to go.
Was he stealing them?
Yes, that's why I called the police.
What is this man's name?
Hal. Harold. Harold Dawes.
The police said you were the only one here.
Well, he left before they got here.
With the notebooks?
No, Claire, don't be stupid. There were over 100 notebooks. He was only stealing one, but he was stealing it so he could give it back to me. So I let him go so he could play with his band on the north side.
His band?
He was late. He wanted me to come with him, but I was like, yeah, right.
Is Harold Dobbs your boyfriend?
No!
Are you sleeping with him?
What? Oh, no! He's a math geek.
He's in a band? A rock band?
No, a marching band. Yes, a rock band.
What's the name of his band?
How should I know?
Harold Dobbs didn't tell you the name of his rock band?
No, I don't know. Look in the paper, they were playing last night. They do a song called Imaginary Number that doesn't exist.
I'm sorry, I'm just trying to understand. Is Harold Dobbs...
Stop saying Harold Dobbs.
Is this person...
Harold Dobbs exists!
I'm sure he does.
He's a mathematician at the University of Chicago. Call the fucking math department.
Don't get upset, I'm just trying to understand. I mean, if you found out some creepy grad student was trying to take some dad's papers and you call the police, I'd understand. And if you're out here partying, drinking with your boyfriend, I'd understand, but the two stories don't go together.
Because you made up the boyfriend story. I was here alone.
Harold Dobbs wasn't here?
No, yes, he was here, but we weren't partying.
You weren't drinking with him?
No.
This was sitting right here. Who are you drinking champagne with?
With no one.
Are you sure?
Yes.
The police said you were abusive. They said you're lucky they didn't haul you in.
These guys were assholes, Claire. They wouldn't go away. They wanted me to fill out a report.
Were you abusive?
This one cop kept spitting on me when he talked. It was disgusting.
You used the word dickhead?
I don't remember.
Did you tell one cop to go fuck the other cop's mother?
No.
That's what they said.
Not with that phrasing.
Strike one of them?
They were trying to come in the house.
Oh my god!
I might have pushed him a little.
They said you were either drunk or disturbed.
They wanted to come in here and search my house.
You called them!
Yes, but I didn't actually want them to come. But they did come. And then they started acting like they owned the place. Pushing me around, calling me girly, smirking at me, laughing. They were assholes.
These guys seemed perfectly nice. They were off duty, and they took the trouble to come back here at the end of their shift to check up on you. They were very polite.
Well, people are nicer to you.
Katie. Would you like to come to New York?
Yes, I told you. I'll come in January.
You could come sooner. We'd love to have you. You could stay with us. It'd be fun.
I don't want to.
Mitch has become an excellent cook. It's like his hobby now. He buys all these gadgets. garlic press, olive oil sprayer. Every night there's something new. Delicious, wonderful meals. And the other day, he made vegetarian chili.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Stay with us for a while. We would have so much fun.
Thanks. I'm okay here.
Chicago is dead. New York is so much more fun. You can't believe it.
The fun thing is really not where my focus is at the moment.
I think New York would be a really fun and safe place.
I don't need a safe place, and I don't want to have any fun. Perfectly fine here.
You look tired. I think you could use some downtime.
Downtime?
Katie, please. You've had a very hard time.
I'm perfectly okay.
I think you're upset and exhausted.
I was fine until you got here.
Yes, but...
Catherine!
Who's that?
Hey, I'm...
Harold Dobbs!
Hi.
Okay? I really don't need this, Claire. I'm fine. You know, I'm totally fine. And then you swoop in here with these questions like, are you okay? Your soothing tone of voice. And oh, the poor policeman. I mean, I think the police can handle themselves! And bananas and... bagels and jojoba and come to New York and vegetarian chili! I mean, it really pisses me off, so just save it.
I'm Claire, Catherine's sister.
Hi, Hal, nice to meet you. I hope it's not too early. I was just wondering if I could get some work done before the if I...
Yes. Sure. That's Harold Dobbs.
Yes.
He's cute. Oh. He's a mathematician.
I think you owe me an apology, Claire.
You need to make some decisions. I shouldn't have tried first thing in the morning.
I don't want an argument.
Maybe Hal would like a bagel?
For a funeral reception, this might have gotten a bit out of control.
Come on, it's great. Come on in.
I'm okay.
We're done playing, I promise.
No, thanks.
Do you want a beer?
I'm okay.
I brought you one.
Okay. How many people are in there?
It's down to about 40.
40?
Just the hardcore partners.
They're my sister's friends.
No, mathematicians. Your sister's friends left hours ago. These guys were really pleased to be asked to participate. They worshipped your dad.
It was Claire's idea.
It was good.
The performance of Imaginary Number was sort of moving.
Good funeral. I mean, not good, but...
No. Yeah.
Can you believe how many people came?
I was surprised.
I think he would have liked it. I'm sorry, it's not my place to...
No. You're right. Everything was better than I thought.
You look great.
Claire gave it to me.
I like it.
It doesn't really fit.
No, Catherine, it's good.
When do you think they'll leave?
No way to know. Mathematicians are insane. I went to this conference in Toronto last fall. I'm young, right? I'm in shape. I thought I could hang with the big boys. Wrong. I've never been so exhausted in my life. 48 straight hours of partying, drinking, drugs, papers, lectures.
Drugs?
Yeah, amphetamines mostly. I mean, I don't. A lot of the older guys are really hooked.
Really?
Yeah, they think they need him.
Why?
They think math's a young man's game. Speed keeps them racing, makes them feel sharp. There's this fear that your creativity peaks at 23 and it's all downhill from there. Once you hit 50, it's over. You might as well teach high school.
That's what my father
said. I don't know. Some people stay prolific.
Not many.
No, you're right. Really original work. It's all young guys.
Young guys?
Young people.
But it is men, mostly.
There are some women.
Who?
There's this woman at Stanford. I can't remember her name.
Sophie Germain.
Sure. I've probably seen her at meetings. I just don't think I've met her.
She was born in Paris in 1776.
So I've definitely never met her.
She was trapped in her house. The French Revolution was going on. The terror. She had to stay inside for safety, and so she passed the time reading in her father's study. The Greeks. Later, she tried to get a real education, but the schools didn't allow women. So she wrote letters. She wrote to Gauss. She used a man's name, Antoine Auguste Leblanc. She sent him some proofs involving a certain kind of prime number. Important work. And he was delighted to correspond with such a brilliant young man. Dad gave me a book about her.
I'm stupid. Sophie Germain, of course.
You know
her. Germain Primes.
Right.
They're famous. Double them and add one and you get another prime. Like two. Two is prime, doubled plus one is five, also prime.
Right. Or 92,305 times 2 to the power of 16,998. Plus 1.
Right.
That's the biggest one. Biggest one now.
Did he ever find out who she was? Gauss?
Yeah. Later, a mutual friend told him the brilliant young man was a woman. He wrote to her. A taste for the mysteries of numbers is excessively rare. But when a person of the sex, which according to our customs and prejudices, must encounter infinitely more difficulties than men to familiarize herself with these thorny researches, succeeds nevertheless in penetrating the most obscure parts of them, then without a doubt she must have the noblest courage, quite extraordinary talents, and superior genius. I memorized it.
I'm sorry, I'm a little drunk.
That's okay. I'm sorry about yesterday. I wasn't helpful. About the work you're doing, take as long as you need upstairs.
You were fine. I was pushing.
I was awful.
No, my timing was terrible. Anyway, you're probably right.
What?
About it being drunk.
Yes.
I read through a lot of the stuff today, just skimming. Except for the book I saw.
Oh God, I'm sorry about that.
No, you were right.
I shouldn't have called the police.
It was my fault.
No.
Anyway, that book, I'm starting to think it's the only lucid one, really. And there's no math in it.
No.
I mean, I'll keep reading, but if I don't find anything in a couple of days...
Back to the drums.
Yeah.
And your own research.
Such as it is.
What's wrong with it?
It's not exactly setting the world on fire.
Oh, come on.
It sucks, basically.
Gerald.
My papers get turned out, and for the right reasons. My stuff is trivial. The big ideas aren't there.
Well, it's not about big ideas. It's work. You've got to chip away at a problem.
It's not what your dad did.
I think it was, in a way. He'd attack a question from the side, from some weird angle, sneak up on it, grind away at it. He was slogging. He was just so much faster than anyone else that from the outside it looked magical.
I don't know.
I'm just guessing.
Plus, the work was beautiful. You could read it for pleasure. It's streamlined, like a 95-mile-per-hour fastball. It's just elegant.
Yeah.
And that's what you can never duplicate. At least I can. It's okay, after a certain point you realize it's not going to happen, you readjust your expectations. I enjoy teaching.
You might come up with something.
I'm 28, remember? On the downhill slope.
Have you tried speed?
Yeah.
So, Hal.
Yep.
What do you do for sex?
What?
At your conferences.
I mean,
isn't that why people hold conferences? Travel? Room service? Tax-deductible sex in big hotel beds?
Maybe, I don't know.
So what do? All you guys?
Well, we are scientists.
So?
So there's a lot of experimentation. Huh.
That was nice.
Really?
Yes.
Again?
Yes.
I always liked you.
You did?
Even before I knew you, I'd catch glimpses of you when you walked to visit your dad's office at school. I wanted to talk to you, but I thought, no, you do not flirt with your doctoral advisor's daughter.
Especially when your advisor's crazy.
Especially then.
You came here once. 4 years ago. Remember?
Sure. I can't believe you do. I was dropping off a draft of my thesis for your dad. Jesus, I was nervous.
You looked nervous.
I can't believe you remember that.
I remember you. I thought you seemed not born.
How long have you been up?
A while.
Did I oversleep?
No.
Is your sister up?
No. She's flying home in a couple hours. I should probably wake her.
Let her sleep. She was doing some pretty serious drinking with the theoretical physicist last night.
I'll make her some coffee when she gets up.
Sunday mornings, usually go out, get the paper, have some breakfast.
Okay.
Do you want to come?
Oh, no. I ought to stick around until Claire leaves.
All right, do you mind if I stay?
No. You can work if you want.
Okay.
Okay.
Should I?
If you want to.
Do you want me to go?
You want to go?
I want to stay here with you.
Oh.
I want to spend as much time with you as I can. I want to spend the day with you, if possible. Unless I'm coming on way too strong and scaring you, in which case I'll begin backpedaling immediately. How embarrassing is it if I say the last night was wonderful?
Well, it's only embarrassing
if I don't agree.
Don't be embarrassed.
Yeah. What's this?
It's a key.
Ah.
Try it.
Where?
Bottom drawer of the desk in my dad's office.
What's in there?
There's one way to find out, Professor.
Now? Okay.
What happened? Thanks a lot for leaving me all alone with them.
Where were your friends?
My stupid friends left. It was only 11 o'clock. They all had to go home and pay their babysitters or bake bread or something. I'm left alone with these lunatics.
Why did you drink so much?
Thought I could keep up with them. I thought they'd stop. They didn't. Oh God, have another tequila.
You want some coffee?
In a minute. That band.
Yeah.
They were terrible.
They were okay. They had fun. I think.
Well, as long as everyone had fun. Your dress turned out all right.
I love it.
You do?
Yeah, it's wonderful.
I was surprised you even wore it.
I love it, Claire. Thanks.
You're welcome. You're in a good mood.
Should I not be?
Are you kidding? No, I'm thrilled. I'm leaving in a few hours.
I know.
The house is a wreck. Don't clean it up yourself. I'll hire someone to come in.
Thanks. Do you want your coffee?
No, thanks. It's no trouble. Hold on a sec, Katie. I'm leaving soon.
You said. I know.
I'd still like you to come to New York.
Yes. January.
I'd like you to move to New York.
Move?
What do you think about it?
For me,
You can stay with me in Metro first. There's plenty of room. Then you could get your own place. I've already scouted some apartments for you. Really cute places.
What would I do in New York?
What are you doing here?
I live here.
You could do whatever you want. You could work, you could go to school.
I don't know, Claire. This is pretty major.
I realize that.
I know you mean well. But I'm just not sure what I want to do. I mean, to be honest, you were right yesterday. I do feel a little confused. I'm tired. It's been a pretty weird couple of years. I think you'd like to take some time to figure things out.
You could do that in New York.
And I could do it here.
But it would be much easier for me to get you set up in an apartment in New York.
I don't need an apartment. I'll stay in the house.
We're selling the house.
What?
I'm selling it.
When?
I was hoping to do the paperwork this week. I know it seems silly.
No one was here looking at the place. Who are you selling it to?
University? They've wanted the block for years.
I live here!
Honey, now that Dad's gone, it doesn't make sense. It's in bad shape. It costs a fortune to heat. It's time to let it go. Mitch agrees. It's a very smart move. We're lucky. We have a great offer.
Where am I supposed to live?
Come to New York.
I can't believe this.
It'll be so good. You deserve a change. This would be a whole new adventure for you.
Why are you doing this?
I want to help.
By kicking me out of my house?
It was my house, too.
But you haven't lived here for years.
I know that. You were on your own. I really regret that, Katie.
Don't.
I know I let you down. I feel awful about it. Now, I'm trying to help.
You want to help now?
Yes.
Dad's dead.
I know.
He's dead. Now that he's dead, you fly in for the weekend and decide you want to help? You're late. Where have you been? Where were you 5 years ago? You weren't helping then.
I was working.
I was here. I lived with him alone.
I was working 14-hour days. I paid every bill here. I paid off the mortgage on this 3-bedroom house while I was living in a studio in Brooklyn.
You had your life. You got to finish school.
You could have stayed in school.
How?
I would have done anything. I told you a million times to do anything you wanted.
And what about Dad? Someone had to take care of him.
He was ill. He should have been in a full-time professional care situation.
He didn't belong in the nut house.
He might have been better off.
How can you say that?
This is where I'm meant to feel guilty, right?
Sure. Go for it.
I'm heartless. My own father!
He needed to be here. In his own house, near the university, near his students, near everything that made him happy.
Maybe. Or maybe some real professional care would have done him more good than rattling around in a filthy house with you looking after him. I'm sorry, Catherine. It's not your fault. It's my fault for letting you do it.
I was right to keep him here.
No.
And what about his remission? 4 years ago, he was healthy for almost a year.
And then he went right downhill again.
He might have been worse in a hospital.
And he might have been better. Did he ever do any work again?
No.
No. And you might have been better.
Better than what?
Living here with him didn't do you any good. You said that yourself. You had so much talent.
I think I'm like Dad.
I think you have some of his talent and some of his tendency toward instability.
Claire? In addition to the cute apartments that you've scouted for me in New York, would you by any chance also have devoted some of your considerable energies towards scouting out another type of living facility for your bughouse little sister?
No, absolutely not. That is not what this is about.
Don't lie to me, Claire. I'm smarter than you.
resources. I've investigated. Oh, all I'm saying is, if you wanted, the doctors in New York and the people are the best.
Fuck
it,
you!
It would be entirely up to you. You wouldn't live anywhere.
I hate you!
Don't yell, please!
I hate
down.
You!
What are you doing here?
How long have you known about this?
A while.
Why didn't you tell me?
I wasn't sure I wanted to.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Well, what's going on?
God, Catherine, thank you.
I thought you'd like to see it. What is it?
It's incredible.
What is it?
Oh, it's a result. I mean, a proof. I think it's a proof. A very long proof. I haven't read it, of course, or checked it, or I don't know if I could check it, but if it's a proof of what I think it's a proof of, it's a very important proof.
What does it prove?
It looks like it proves a theorem, a mathematical theorem about prime numbers, something mathematicians have been trying to prove since there were mathematicians, basically. Most people thought it couldn't be done.
Where did you find it?
In your father's study. Kathy told me about it.
You know what this is?
Sure.
Is it good?
Yes.
It's incredible, if it checks out.
What does it say?
I don't know yet. I've only read the first few pages.
But what does it mean?
It means that during a time when everyone thought your dad was crazy, or barely functioning, he was doing some of the most important mathematics in the world. If it checks out, it means you publish instantly. It means people all over the world are going to want to talk to the person who found this notebook.
Kathy?
I didn't find it.
Yes, you did.
No.
Well, did you find it, or did Hal find it?
I didn't find it.
I didn't find it. I wrote it.
Hopeless like surrender. Pasta would be easy. Yes, yes, it would. Pasta. It doesn't mean anything. It's just a euphemism people invented when they got sick of eating spaghetti. I don't know.
Well, I don't know what to get.
I'll jump.
No.
I'll do it.
No, Dad, rest.
I wanted to take a walk anyway.
Are you sure?
Yes, what about a walk to the lake? You and me.
All right.
I would love to go to the lake. Then on the way home, we can stop at the store, see what jumps out at us.
It's warm. It would be nice, if you're up to it.
You're damn right I'm up to it. We'll work up an appetite. Give me 10 seconds, let me put the stuff away and we're out the door.
I'm going to school.
When?
I'm gonna start at Northwestern at the end of the month.
Northwestern?
They were great about my credits. They're taking me in as a sophomore. I wasn't sure when to talk to you about it.
Northwestern?
Yes.
What's wrong with Chicago?
You still teach there, I'm sorry. It's too weird, taking classes in your department.
It's a long drive.
Not that long. Half an hour.
Well, still, twice a day.
Dad, I live there.
You actually want to live in Evanston?
Yes. I'll still be close. I can come home whenever you want. You've been well. Really well, for almost 7 months. I don't think you need me here every minute of the day.
This is all a done deal. You're in.
Yes.
You're sure?
Yes.
Who pays for it?
They're giving me a free ride, Dad. They've been great.
Well, on tuition, sure, but what about food? Books, gas, clothes, meals, help? Do you plan to have a social life?
I don't know.
You've got to pay your own way on dates. At least the other ones say the first three, otherwise they expect something.
The money will be fine. Claire's gonna help out.
When did you talk to Claire?
I don't know. A couple weeks ago?
You talked to her before you talked to me?
There were a lot of details to work out. She was great. She offered to take care of all the expenses.
This is a big step, a different city.
It's not even a long-distance phone call.
It's a huge place. They're serious up there. I mean, serious. Yeah, the football's a disaster, but the math guys don't get around. You haven't been in school. Are you sure you're ready? You can get buried up there.
I'll be all right.
You're way behind.
I know.
A year at least.
Thank you, I know. Look, I don't know if this is a good idea. I don't know if I can handle the work. I don't know if I can handle any of it.
For Christ's sakes, Catherine, you should have talked to me.
Dad, come on. It took a while to set this up. And until very recently, you weren't...
You just said yourself, I'm fine.
Yes, but I didn't know. I hoped, but I didn't know. No one knew if this would last. I told myself to wait until I was sure about you again. That you were feeling okay. Consistently okay.
So I'm to take this conversation as a vote of confidence? Well, I'm honored.
Take it however you want. I believed you'd get better.
Well, thank you very much.
But don't thank me. I had to. I was living with you.
All right, that's enough, Catherine. Let's stay on the subject.
This is the subject. There were library books stacked up to the ceiling. Do you remember that? You were trying to decode messages.
The fucking books are gone. I took them back myself. Why did you bring that garbage up? Mr. Dolls.
Hi.
Sorry.
I hope it's not a bad time.
Yes, it is, actually. You couldn't have picked worse.
I
you interrupted that argument.
I can come back.
That's all right. We needed a break.
Are you sure?
Yes, the argument was about dinner. We don't know what to eat. What's your suggestion?
There's a great pasta place.
No! No! Jesus God, no! No!
Sorry, wrong answer, but thank you for trying.
I can come back.
Where are you going?
Inside.
What about dinner?
What about him?
What are you doing here, Dobbs?
My timing sucks. I am really sorry.
No, no.
I'll come to your office.
Stop. Sit down. I'm glad you're here. Don't let the dinner thing throw you. You'll bounce back. This should be easier. Let's back off the problem. Let it breathe. Come at it again when it's not looking.
Fine. Excuse me.
Oh, sorry. I'm being rude. Hal, this is my daughter, Catherine. Don't go. Have a drink with us, Catherine. Harold Dobbs.
Hi.
Hi.
Hal's doing his PhD. Very promising stuff. Unfortunately for him, his work coincided with my return to the department, and he got stuck with me.
I've been very lucky.
How long have you been at U of C?
Well, I've been working my thesis for about...
Hal's in our infinite program. As he approaches completion of his dissertation, time approaches infinity! Would you like a drink, Hal?
Yes, I would, and with all due respect.
Really? You must have had an interesting few months.
Worst summer of my life.
Congratulations.
It's just a draft. Based on everything we talked about last spring, I wasn't sure if I should wait until the quarter started, or give it to you now, or hold off, do another draft, but I just figured, fuck it, let's just get it over with, so I thought I'd stop by and see if you were home, and then I...
Drink this.
Thank you. I figured, I don't know if it feels done. Maybe it is.
Wrong. If it feels done, there are major errors.
That's
okay. That's good. We'll find them and fix them. Don't worry. You're on your way to a solid career. You'll be teaching younger, more irritating versions of yourself in no time. Catherine's in the math department at Northwestern, Hal.
Oh, who are you working with?
I'm just starting this fall. Undergrad.
Well, she's starting in, 3 weeks?
A little more.
They have some good people at Northwestern. O'Donohue, Kaminsky?
Yes.
They will work your ass off.
No.
You'll have to run pretty hard to catch up.
I think I can do it.
Of course you can.
You must be excited.
I am.
A first year of school can be great.
Yeah?
Sure, all the new people, new places. Getting out of the house?
Yes.
Or not, I mean, I...
Absolutely! Get out of here, thank God! I'll be glad to see the back of her.
You will.
Of course. Maybe I want to have the place to myself for a while. Did that ever occur to you? It's awful the way children sentimentalize their parents. We could use some quiet around here.
Oh, don't worry, I'll come back. I'll be here every Sunday cooking up big vats of pasta to last me through the week.
Strut around Evanston, embarrass you in front of your classmates.
Good, so we'll be in touch.
Sure. If you ever get stuck with a problem, give me a call.
Okay, same to you.
Fine. Make sure to get me your number. I'm actually looking forward to getting some work done.
Oh, what are you working on?
No, nothing. Nothing at the moment. Which I'm glad of, really. This is the time of year you don't want to be tied down to anything. You want to be outside. I love Chicago in September. Perfect skies. Sailboats on the water. Cubs losing. Warm. The sun's still hot with the occasional blast of Arctic wind to keep you on your toes during the winter. Students coming back. Bookstores full. Everybody busy. I was in a bookstore the other day. Completely full. Students buying books, browsing. Students do a hell of a lot of browsing, don't they? Just browsing. You see them shuffling around with their backpacks, goofing off. Call it loitering, except every once in a while they pick up a book and they flip the pages. Browsing. I admire it. It's an honest way to kill an afternoon. In the back of a used bookstore, going through a crate of somebody's old record albums. Not looking for anything, just looking, what the hell. Touching the old book jackets, seeing what somebody else threw out, seeing what somebody else underlined. Maybe you find something great, like a thriller with a painted cover from the 40s. Or a textbook one of your professors used when he was a student. His name is written in it very carefully. Yeah, I like it. I like watching the students, wondering what they're gonna buy, what they're gonna read. What kinds of ideas they'll come up with when they settle down and get to work. I'm not doing much right now. It's a stereotype that happens to be true. It does get harder. Unfortunately for me. Unfortunately for you. For all of us.
Maybe you'll get lucky.
Well, maybe I will. Maybe you'll pick up where I left off.
Don't hold your breath.
Don't underestimate yourself.
Anyway.
Another drink?
Kathy, pal?
No, thanks.
Thanks. I really should get going.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
All right, well. I'll call you when I've looked at this. Don't think about it till then. Enjoy yourself. See some movies.
Okay.
You can come by my office in a week. Call it
the 11th.
Yes, well... I am sorry. I used to have a pretty good memory for numbers. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
I'm so sorry. I'm embarrassed.
Dad, don't be stupid.
I didn't get you anything.
You don't have to.
We are going out.
You don't have to.
I didn't want to shop and cook. Let's get the hell out of this neighborhood.
Where do you want
to
go?
Let's go to Northside, or Chinatown, or Greektown. I don't know what's good anymore.
Whatever you want.
No, whatever you want, goddammit, Catherine. It's your birthday.
Steak.
Done.
There's a beer. Really cold beer. Really cheap beer.
Yes.
That Chicago beer that's watery with no flavor. You can just drink gallons of it.
Well, they just pump the water out of Lake Michigan in bottles. I can taste for it myself.
I need a steak, grilled really black, and potatoes, and cream spinach.
I think I know a place. If it's still there, I think it'll do the trick.
And dessert?
Well, that goes without saying. It's your birthday. Hooray! And there's a solution to our dinner problem. Thank you for reminding me, Harold Dobbs.
We're being rude. Do you want to come?
No, I shouldn't.
Oh, why not? Please, come.
Come on.
I'm sorry, I can't. I have plans. Thank you, though. Happy birthday.
Thanks. Well, I'll let you out.
I'll see you on the 11th, pal. Great.
I'm just going to change my clothes, Dad. I'll be down in a sec.
September 4th. A good...
Yes.
You mean Dad dictated it to you?
No, it's my proof. It's mine, I wrote it.
When?
I started after I quit school. I finished a few months before Dad died.
Did he see it?
No. He didn't know I was working on it. It wouldn't have mattered to him anyway, he was too sick.
I don't understand. You did this by yourself?
Yes.
It's in Dad's notebook.
I used one of his blank books. There were a bunch of them upstairs.
Tell me exactly where you found this.
In your father's study.
In his desk.
Hold on.
Gave him...
Where did you find it?
In the bottom drawer of the desk in your father's study. A locked drawer. Catherine gave me the key.
Why was the drawer locked?
It's mine. It's the drawer I keep my private things in. I've used it for years.
Was there anything else in the drawer?
No.
No, that's the
Can
only...
Can I see it? I'm sorry, I just... The book was in the... I told him where to find it. Gave him the key. You wrote wrote this incredible thing and you didn't tell anyone?
I'm telling you both now. After I dropped out of school, I had nothing to do. I was depressed. Really depressed. But at a certain point, I decided, fuck it. I don't need them. It's just math. I can do it on my own. So I started working here. I worked at night after Dad had gone to sleep. It was hard, but I did it.
Catherine, sorry, but I just find this very hard to believe.
Claire, I wrote the proof.
I'm sorry.
Claire.
This is Dad's handwriting.
It's not.
It looks exactly like it.
It's my writing.
I'm sorry.
Ask Hal. He's been looking at Dad's writing for weeks.
I don't know.
Hal, come on.
What does it look like?
It looks... I don't know what Catherine's handwriting looks like.
It looks like that!
Okay. Okay.
I think... You know what? I think it's early and people are tired and not in the best state to make decisions about emotional things. So maybe we should just all take a breath.
You don't believe me.
I don't know. I really don't know anything about this.
Well, never mind. I don't know why I expected you to believe me about anything.
Could you tell us the proof? That would show it was yours.
You wouldn't understand it.
Tell it to Hal.
We could talk it through together. It might take a while.
You can't use the book.
For God's sake, it's 40 pages long. I didn't memorize it. It's not a muffin recipe. This is stupid. It's my book, my writing, my key, my drawer, my proof. Hal, tell her.
Tell her what?
Whose book is that?
I don't know.
What is the matter with you? You've been looking at this other stuff. You know there's nothing even remotely like this.
Catherine.
Hey, we'll sit down. We'll talk through the proof together. If Claire will please give me my book back.
All right, talk him through it.
That could take days, and it still wouldn't show that she wrote it.
Why not?
Your dad might have written it and explained it to you later. I'm not saying he did, I'm just saying there's no proof that you wrote this.
Of course there isn't, but come on. He didn't do this. He couldn't have. I mean, even in his good year, he couldn't work. You know that. You're supposed to be a scientist.
You're right. Here's my suggestion. I know 3 or 4 guys in the department. Very sharp, disinterested people who knew your father, knew his work. Let me take this to them.
What?
I'll tell them we found something potentially major, we're not sure about the authorship. I'll sit down with them, we'll go through the thing carefully,
Good. And
figure out exactly what we've got. It would only take a couple of days and then we'd have a lot more information.
I think that's an excellent suggestion.
You can't.
Kathy.
No, you can't take it.
I'm not taking it.
This is what you wanted.
Oh, come on.
You don't waste any time, do you? No hesitation. You can't wait to show them your brilliant discovery.
I'm trying to determine what this is.
I'm telling you what it is.
You don't know.
I wrote it.
It's your father's handwriting. At least it looks an awful lot like the writing in the other books. Maybe your writing looks exactly like his. I don't know.
It does look like his. I didn't show this to anyone else. I could have. I wanted you to be the first to see it. And I didn't know I wanted that until last night. It's me. I trusted you.
I know.
Was I wrong?
No, I...
And I should have known that she wouldn't believe me. But why don't you?
This is one of his notebooks. The exact same kind he used.
I told you, I just used one of his blank books. There were extras.
There aren't any extras in the study.
Well, there were when I started writing the proof. I bought them for him. He must have used the rest up later.
And the writing?
You want to test the handwriting?
No, he could have dictated to you, for Christ's sake. It still doesn't make sense.
Why not?
I'm a mathematician.
Yes.
I know how hard it would be to come up with something like this. I mean, it's impossible. You'd have to be your dad, basically. Your dad at the peak of his powers.
I'm a mathematician, too.
Not like your father.
Oh, he's the only one who could have done this?
The only one I know.
Are you sure?
Your father was the
most... because you and the rest of the geeks worshipped him doesn't mean he wrote this proof how.
He was the best. My generation hasn't produced anything like him. He revolutionized the field twice before he was 22. I'm sorry, Catherine, but you took some class at Northwestern for a few months.
My education wasn't at Northwestern. It was living in this house for 25 years.
Even so, it doesn't matter. This is too advanced. I don't even understand most of it.
You think it's too advanced?
Yeah.
It's too advanced for you.
You could not have done this work.
But what if I did?
Well, what if?
It would be a real disaster for you, wouldn't it? And for the other geeks who barely finished their PhDs, who are marking time, doing lame research, and bragging about the conferences they go to. Wow. Playing in an awful band and whining that they're intellectually past it at 28 because they are!
Catherine, I thought you were leaving.
I had to delay my flight.
Is Catherine here?
I don't think this is a good time, Hal.
Could I talk to her?
Not now.
What's the matter?
She's sleeping.
Could I wait here until she gets up?
She's been sleeping since yesterday. She won't get up. She won't eat, won't talk to me. I couldn't go home. I'm gonna wait until she seems okay to travel.
Jesus, I'm sorry.
Yes.
I'd like to talk to her.
Not. I don't think that's a good idea.
Has she said anything?
About you? No.
Yesterday, I know I didn't do what she wanted.
Neither of us did.
I didn't know what to say. I feel awful.
Why did you sleep with her?
I'm sorry, that's none of your business.
Bullshit! I have to take care of her. It's a little bit harder with you jerking her around.
I wasn't jerking her around, it just happened.
Your timing was not great.
It wasn't my timing, it was both of our
timings. Why did you do it? You know what she's like. She's fragile and you took advantage of her.
It's what we both wanted. I didn't mean to hurt her.
You did.
I'd like to talk to Catherine, please.
You can't.
Are you taking her away?
Yes.
To New York?
Yes.
Just gonna drag her to New York?
If I have to.
Don't you think she should have some say in whether or not she goes?
If she's not going to speak, what else can I do?
Let me try. Let me talk to her.
Hal, give up. This has nothing to do with you.
I know her. She's tougher than you think, Claire.
What?
She can handle herself. She can handle talking to me. Maybe she'd like it. Maybe it would help.
Maybe she'd like it? Are you out of your mind? You're the reason she's up there right now. You have no idea what she needs. You don't know her. She's my sister. Jesus, you fucking mathematicians. You don't think. You don't know what you're doing. You stagger around creating these catastrophes, and it's people like me who end up flying in to clean them up. She needs to get out of Chicago, out of this house. I'll give you my number in New York. You can call her once she's settled there. That's it. That's the deal.
Okay.
I don't mean to be rude, but I have a lot to do.
There's one more thing. You're not gonna like it.
Sure, take the notebook.
Hold
on a sec, I'll get it for you.
thought this would be hard.
Don't worry. I understand. It's very sweet you want to see Catherine, but of course you'd like to see the notebook, too.
No, it's my duty. As a professional, I can't turn my back on the necessity of the...
Relax. I don't care. Take it. What would I do with it?
Are you sure?
Yes, of course.
You trust me with this?
Yes.
You just said I don't know what I'm doing.
I think you're a little bit of an idiot, but you're not dishonest. Someone needs to figure out what's in there. I can't do it. It should be done here, at Chicago. My father would like that. Once you decide what we've got, let me know what the family should do.
Thank you.
Don't thank me. It's by far the most convenient option available. I put my card in there. Call whenever you want.
Okay.
Hal?
Yeah.
Could you tell me about it? Proof. I'm just curious.
That depends. How much math do you have?
I'm a currency analyst. It helps to be very quick with numbers. I am. I probably inherited about 1/1000th of my father's ability. It's enough. Catherine got more. I'm not sure how much.
It's 30 degrees.
I know.
Don't you need a coat?
Don't you think I can make that assessment for myself?
Aren't you cold?
Of course I am. I'm freezing my ass off.
So what are you doing out here?
Thinking, writing.
You're gonna freeze.
It's too hot in the house. The radiators dry out the air. Also the clanking, I can't concentrate. If the house weren't so old, we'd have central air heating, but we don't, so I have to come out here to get any work done.
I'll turn off the radiators. They won't make any noise. Come inside. It isn't safe.
I'm okay.
I've been calling. Didn't you hear the phone?
It's a distraction.
I didn't know what was going on. I had to drive all the way down here.
I can see that.
I had to skip class.
Sorry, Catherine, but it's a question of priorities, and work takes priority, you know that.
You're working?
Oh, goddammit, I am working. Well, the machinery is working, Catherine. It's on full blast. All cylinders are firing. I'm on fire. That's why I came out here to cool off. I haven't felt like this for years.
You're kidding.
No.
I don't believe it.
Oh, I don't believe it either, but it's true. It all started about a week ago. I came downstairs, made a cup of coffee, and before I could pour in the milk, it was like someone turned a light on in my head.
Really?
No. Not a light. The whole power grid! I lit up, and it's like no time at all has passed since I was 21.
You're kidding.
No! I'm back! I'm back in touch with the source! The font! The... whatever the source of my creativity was all those years ago, I'm back in contact with it again. I'm sitting on it. It's a geyser, and I'm shooting straight up into the air on top of it.
My God.
Now, I'm not talking about divine inspiration. It's going to take work to shape these things. I'm not saying it won't be a tremendous amount of work. It will be a tremendous amount of work, but the raw material is there. It's like I've been driving in traffic, and now the lanes are opening up before me, and I can accelerate. I see whole landscapes, places for the work to go, new ideas, revolutionary possibilities. I'm going to get whole branches of the profession talking to each other. I'm sorry, I'm being rude. How's school?
Fine.
You're working hard?
Sure.
Faculty treating you all right?
Yes. Dad?
Make any friends?
Of course.
Dating?
Dad, hold on.
No details necessary if you don't want to provide them. I'm just interested.
School's great. I want to talk about what you're doing.
Great, let's talk.
This work?
Yes.
Can I see it?
Nothing's actually complete, to be honest.
Oh, I don't mind.
I think we're talking years.
That's okay. I don't care. Just let me see anything.
You really want to?
Yes.
You're genuinely interested.
Dad, of course.
Of course, it's your field.
Yes.
You know how happy that makes me.
Yes.
I think there's enough here to keep me working the rest of my life. Not just me. I'm starting to imagine I was finished, Catherine. Really finished. I mean, don't get me wrong, I was grateful I could go back to the office, have a life, but secretly, I was terrified I'd never work again. Did you know that?
I wonder.
I was absolutely fucking terrified. But then I remembered something, and a part of the terror went away. I remembered you. Your creative years were just beginning. You'd get your degree, do your own work. If you hadn't gone into math, that would have been fine. Claire's done well for herself. I'm satisfied with her. I'm proud of you. I don't mean to embarrass you. It's part of the reason we have children. We hope they'll survive us, accomplish what we could. But now that I'm back in the game, I admit, I've got another idea. A better one.
What?
I know you have your own work. I don't want you to neglect that. You can't neglect it. But I could probably use some help. Work with me. If you want to. We can work it out with your class schedule. I can help you with that. I made some calls. Talk to your teachers. I'm getting ahead of myself. Ah, well, Jesus, look, enough bullshit. You asked to see something, here it is. I dropped something out. General outline for a proof. Major result. Important. It's not finished yet, but you can probably see where it's going. Let's see. Here. It's very rough.
Inside.
The gaps might make it hard to follow. We can talk it through.
You're cold. Let's go in.
Maybe we could work on this together. This might be a great place to start. What about it? What do you think? Let's do some work together.
Not now. I'm cold too. It's really freezing out here. Let's go in.
I'm telling you, it's stifling in there, goddammit, the radiators. Look, read out the first couple of lines. That's how we start. You read, and we go line by line, out loud, through the argument. See if there's a better way, a shorter way. Let's collaborate.
No, come on.
I've been waiting years for this. This is something I've wanted to do. Let's talk it through.
We can't do it out here. It's freezing cold. I'm taking you in.
Not until we talk about the proof.
No.
God damn it, Catherine! Open that goddamn book and read me the lines!
Let x equal the quantity of all quantities of x. Let x equal the cold. It is cold in December. The months of cold equal November through February. There are 4 months of cold and 4 of heat, leaving 4 months of indeterminate temperature. In February it snows. In March the lake is a lake of ice. In September the students come back and the bookstores are full. Let x equal the number of full bookstores. The number of books approaches infinity as the number of months of cold approaches 4. I will never be as cold now as I will in the future. The future of cold is infinite. The future of heat is the future of cold. The bookstores are infinite, and so are never full except in September.
Go inside.
I'm cold.
We'll warm you up.
Don't leave. Please.
I won't. Let's go. Coffee. It's all right, isn't it? We have a place where we buy all our coffee. They roast it themselves. They have an old roaster down in the basement. You can smell it on the street. Some mornings you can smell it from our place. 4 stories up. It's wonderful. Manhattan's best, some magazine wrote about. Who knows, but it is very good.
Sounds good.
You'll like it.
Good.
You look nice.
Thanks. So do you.
It's bright.
Yes.
One of the things I do miss. All the space, the light. You could sit out here all morning.
It's not that warm.
Are you cold?
Not really.
It has gotten chilly. I'm sorry. Do you want to go in?
I'm okay.
I just thought it might be nice to have a quick cup of coffee out here.
No. It is.
Plus, the kitchen's all put away. If you're cold.
I'm not. Not really.
Want your sweater?
Yeah.
That time of year.
Yes. You can feel it coming.
Honey, there's no hurry.
I know.
If you want to hang out, be alone for a while.
No. It's no big deal.
You have to leave for 20 minutes or so.
I know. Thanks, Claire.
You're all packed.
Yes.
If you miss anything, it doesn't really matter. The movers will send us everything next month. I know this is hard.
It's fine.
This is the right decision.
I know.
I want to do everything I can to make this a smooth transition for you. So does Mitch.
Good.
The actual departure is the hardest part. Once we get there, we can relax, enjoy ourselves.
I know.
You'll love New York.
Can't wait.
You'll love it. It's the most exciting city.
I know.
It's not like Chicago, but it's really alive.
I've read about that.
I think you'll truly feel at home there.
You know what I'm really looking forward to?
What? seeing Broadway musicals.
Mitch can get us tickets to whatever you'd like.
And Rockefeller Center in winter, all the skaters.
Well?
Also, the many fine museums.
I know how hard this is for you.
Listening to you say how hard it is for me is what's hard for me.
Once you're there, you'll see all the possibilities that are available.
Restraints. Lithium, electroshock.
Schools! In the New York area alone, there's NYU, Columbia.
Right, college days. Football games, road trips, necking on the quad.
Well, if that's not what you want, we can help you find a job. Mitch has terrific contacts all over town.
Does he know anyone in the phone sex industry?
I want to make this as easy a transition as I can.
It's gonna be easy, Claire. It's gonna be so fucking easy, you won't believe it.
Thank you.
I'm gonna sit quietly on the plane to New York and live quietly in my cute apartment and answer Dr. von Heinrich's questions very politely.
You can see any doctor you like, or you can see no doctor.
I would like to see a doctor called Dr. von Heinrich. Please find one. I would like him to wear a monocle. And I'd like him to have a very soft, very well-upholstered couch, so that I'll be perfectly comfortable while I'm blaming everything on you.
Don't come.
No, I'm coming.
Stay here. See how you do.
I could.
You can't take care of yourself for 5 days.
Bullshit.
You slept all week. I had to cancel my flight. I missed a week of work. I was this close to taking you to the hospital.
I was tired.
You were completely out of it, Catherine. You weren't speaking.
I didn't want to talk to you.
Stay here if you hate me so much.
And do what?
You're the genius! Figure it out!
Here. I saw clearly up front, I wasn't sure. This fucking thing checks out. I've been over it twice with two sets of guys, old geeks and young geeks. It is weird. I don't know where some of the techniques came from. Some of the moves are very hard to follow, but we can't find anything wrong with it. There might be something wrong with it, but we can't find it. I have not slept. It works. I thought you might want to know.
I already knew.
I had to swear these guys to secrecy. See, they were jumping out of their skins. One email is all over. I think we're safe. I threatened them. They're physical cowards. I had to see you.
I'm leaving.
I know, just wait a minute.
What do you want? You have the book. She told me you came by for it and she gave it to you. You can do whatever you want with it. Publish it.
Catherine.
Get Claire's permission and publish it. She doesn't care. She doesn't know anything about it anyway.
I don't want Claire's permission.
You want mine? Publish. Go for it. Have a press conference. Tell the world what my father discovered.
I don't want to.
Or fuck my father. Pass it off as your own work. Who cares? Write your own ticket to any math department in the country.
I don't think your father wrote it.
Thought so last week?
That was last week. I spent this week reading the proof. I think I understand it more or less. You use a lot of newer techniques, things that were developed in the last decade or so. Elliptic curves, modular forms. I think I learned more mathematics this week than I did in 4 years of grad school.
So
the proof is very hip.
Get some sleep, pal.
What was your father doing these last 10 years? He wasn't well, was he?
He'd done.
I don't think he would have been able to master those new techniques.
But he was a genius.
But he was nuts.
So he read about them later.
Maybe. The books he would have needed are upstairs. Your dad dated everything. Even his most incoherent entries he dated. There are no dates in this.
handwriting?
Looks like your dad's. Parents and children sometimes have similar handwriting, especially if they spend a lot of time together.
Interesting theory.
I like it.
I like it too. It's what I told you last week.
I know.
You blew it.
It's
too bad. The rest of it was really good. All of it. I loved your dad. I've always liked you. I'd like to spend every minute with you. It's killer stuff. You got laid, and you got the notebook. You're a genius.
You're giving me way too much credit. I don't expect you to be happy with me. I just hoped to discuss some of this thing before you left. Purely professional. I don't expect anything else.
Forget it.
I mean, we have questions. Working on this must have been amazing. I'd love to just hear you talk about some of it.
No.
I mean, you'll have to deal with it eventually, though. You'll have to talk to someone. You'll have to get it published. You can't ignore it. Take it at least, then I'll go. Here.
I don't want it.
Catherine, I'm trying to correct things.
You can't! Do you hear me? Do you think you figured something out? You run over here so pleased with yourself because you changed your mind. Now you're certain. You're so sloppy. You don't know anything. The book, the math, the dates, the writing, all that stuff you decided with your buddies. It's just evidence. It doesn't finish the job. It doesn't prove anything.
Okay, what would?
Nothing. You should have trusted me.
I know. So, Claire sold the house.
Yes.
Stay in Chicago. You're an adult.
She wants me in New York. She wants to look after me.
Do you need looking after?
She thinks I do.
You looked after your dad for 5 years.
So maybe it's my turn. I kick and scream. But I don't know. Being taken care of doesn't sound so bad. And the house is a wreck, let's face it. It was my dad's house.
Nice house.
It's old.
I guess.
It's drafty as hell. The winters are rough.
That's just Chicago.
Either it's freezing inside or the steam's on full blast and you're stifling.
I like cold weather. It keeps you alert.
Wait a few years.
I've lived here all my life.
Yeah?
Sure. Just like you.
Still. I don't think I should spend another winter here.
There is nothing wrong with you.
I think I'm like my dad.
I think you are too.
I'm afraid I'm like my dad.
You're not him.
Maybe I will be.
Maybe. Maybe you'll be better.
It didn't feel amazing. Or what word did you use?
Yeah, amazing.
Yeah. It's just connecting the dots. Some nights I could connect 3 or 4. Some nights they'd be really far apart. I'd have no idea how to get to the next one. If there was a next one.
You really never knew?
No. I worked after midnight. He was usually in bed.
Every night?
No. When I got stuck, I'd watch TV. Some nights he'd come down and sit with me. We'd talk. Not about math, he couldn't. About the movie we were watching. I'd explain the stories. Or about fixing the heat. Said we didn't want to. We liked the radiators, even though they clanked in the middle of the night and made the air dry. Or we'd plan breakfast, talk about what we were going to eat together in the morning. Those nights were usually pretty good.
I know it works, but all I can see are the compromises, the approximations, places where it's stitched together. It's lumpy. That stuff was way more elegant. When I was young.
Talk me through. Whatever's bothering you, maybe you'll improve it.
I don't know.
Pick anything. Give it a shot. Maybe you'll discover something elegant.
Here.